Carry forth.
Hey, everybody. So now, before I go on with what we're going to call some hammock knots, and I'm not going to show every knot. Some of that you got to find. I'm going to show you the Beckett hitch. I'm going to show you the J-bend. I know you can hardly stand the excitement, and I'd be giddy too if I were you. But if you refer back to part one, you'll see that I use some hardware hooking my tree strap to the tree, mainly a Dutch clip or a carabiner. And later you'll see how I use a thing called a Dutch beaner to hook my continual loop from my hammock to my other suspension. I'm a whoopee sling marlin spike toggle guy, which goes to a tree strap, or whatever kind of suspension you may want to hook to your hammock. You can use a Dutch beaner, which is a little small beaner that has a good strength on the pull, and I use them a lot so I can switch suspensions from hammock to hammock, and also it works as a rain break. And if you don't know what a rain break is, I have a video on it, but a lot of new hammockers don't know that rain can run down your suspension sometimes, hit the end of your hammock, get stuff wet. So a simple shoelace on your suspension under your tarp, it's gonna do you any good outside your tarp. You gotta have it under your tarp. I don't wanna put my socks on over my boots and get you confused. Let's just pretend I hadn't even talked about that yet. But there are those who don't want any hardware. So we're just gonna show a couple of knots you can tie. They're really fun, they're great hammock knots, and easy to adjust. So, shall we? Yeah, you might just have to wait a little bit here because I just got comfortable. By the way, I'm being suspended on my foot end by the Beckett hitch knot. Shall we? Let's do. That kind of hurt me. And on these knots, practice them. I'll show you how to do them. Be careful with the knot. Make sure you do it right. It's always good, you know, remember in a hammock, only hang as high as you're willing to fall. And even a short fall on concrete, if you hit your spine or your elbow, hurts, like your tailbone, man, that smarts. Elbow hurts, back of your head, of course, that hurts, even your heel. So be careful. So practice your knot, put something soft under you, go get a pillow off the couch or something like that and put it under you before you get in your hammock and really test that. Once you know that knot is tied securely and properly, you are good to go and you pass my test. So let's carry forth, shall we? Here we have the Beckett hitch already tied. Using my tree strap here, my webbing, going up to my tree, using my Dutch clip. Remember, if you don't want to use the Dutch clip, you can just string the webbing through itself. Show that on part one. I'll say that over and over. You can't say it enough. Hey, look, I know people skip to these videos and don't pay attention. Think you're kidding me? You think I even watch all of me? Come on. So, and here, as we've talked about before, that's just a continual loop that's on the end of my hammock here. Here's one of the most important things on the Beckett hitch. When you tie that knot, see how you can see that little bit right there at the top of the continual loop? If you don't see your knot, if you don't see that continual loop at the top of your knot, you have tied it incorrectly and you will fall. You have tied it incorrectly and you will fall. You have tied it incorrectly and you will fall. So now I will pull this out, as you can kind of see here in this demonstration. And I've been in this, it's got a little weight, so I'll tug, bam, it comes right loose. So here's how we're gonna tie the Beckett hitch. There's my continual loop, all right? I'm gonna take my webbing and I'm gonna pull it all the way through the continual loop, like that. Now what I do is I look down my hammock and I like my foot end a little bit higher, so I'm just eyeballing here. And often, sometimes when you tie these knots, it'll slip just a little bit when you're done. So maybe err a little bit on the high side. I pinch mine. All right, I'm gonna make a loop like this. Slowly, there's my continual loop. It's kinda like making this shape. I use my little finger to grab that part and then I pull that through and there's my knot. And now you watch it as I go sit in my hammock. And that is it. Did y'all catch all that? Do I need to tie that knot again for you slower, even more?
Slower. I will go get my stuff and do it again. again.
So I'm going to pull it free. All right. So we're going to bring the continual loop up to where we want it. I pinch it with my fingers, right? Then I'm going to take my webbing right here. I use my little finger right there to hold it. And I reach in through this loop. It's kind of like a marlin spike in a strange way. I pull it through as far as you want. I could see that bit of my continual loop right there. And that, my friends, is how it's done. And then when you want to take it out, you simply pull it and it's free. One more time. Pull it up. Pinch it. Make this sort of a shape. I'm going to reach these fingers through. Grab the tail end. Pull it through. Pull it tight. And now I watch it as I sit in it, and it does not move. Beckett hitch, and it's not Samuel Beckett. He was more of a writer and a drinker, and he was a great author, but not much of a knot tier, as far as I know. All right, what I got tied in there right now, the knot that is in there, that is called a J-bend. It's another fairly easy knot to tie for a hammock. I find it just a little harder to get my exact height. Some people differ, some people are the other way. But like I say, I always want my foot end a little higher. So sometimes with knots, you gotta tie and untie a couple of times. That's why with my whoopee slings and cinch buckles and certain things, you can pull it right where you want. And you know, like I said, nothing is perfect in this hammock world except for the sleep. And is there really perfection in this world? No. But I seek it, but I never get it. I am the imperfect perfectionist. So anyway, enough of that. Let's take a look at the J-bend. Now one thing, when you pull your J-bend free, you're pulling your whole hammock free. So here's the end of my hammock. I got my continual loop. I'm holding it right there. I will just kind of hook it around my hand while I tie the knot. First thing I'm going to do is tie a marlin spike, but I'm basically just looping it over itself. I reach my fingers through from underneath and I grab through. So I have made this little kind of a knot right there. Now I'm going to take this, it's a little fiddly here. I'm going to take this end, my continual loop, and put that through the marlin spike. And the marlin spike requires tightening down like that. All right. Now I have this free end of my continual loop, and I'm going to take the free end of my webbing, and pull that through, and it'll slide down. And what I just did with that free end, that catches the continual loop right there, much like the toggle does on a tree strap, whoopee sling, marlin spike, toggle suspension. That would be the TSWS-TMS suspension. That is your J-bend. And now let's watch it while I get in the hammock. I even bounced around a bit and it stayed right where it was. So then I'm going to take my free end of my strap when I'm done, not the loopy end, and I'm going to pull it while holding my hammock, and the whole thing will come loose. Again, free end, marlin spike, which I'm going to cross, fingers through, tie this little loopy knot, put my finger in it for a second, grab my continual loop, put that through, hold the continual loop, tighten that marlin spike. Now it needs something through here so it doesn't slide through, and that something is the extra webbing. Bam! Done. The J-bend. So now I'm going to move the camera back a little bit and we'll do it again. Take the hammock. I've got it here. I have to estimate where my marlin spike will be. I'm going to say right here. Now I take my continual loop, pull it through the marlin spike, tighten the marlin spike, put the free end of my strap through, tug it, boom. Come around, take a wee bow, and then crawl in. When done, step up, grab hammock, pull, walk away.